Welcome back, everyone, to more Tales of the Abyss 3DS. Welcome to part 30 already. In the previous part, we took care of some huge water creature called Ancephalopic, or that creature. And in this episode, we're having some interesting scenes coming up, so let's jump straight into it. As soon as you're trying to leave this area, which is just one area further, I believe, you'll run into some cutscenes, which really matter for the game. Makes it so much better.
Welcome back! An earthquake!
Ugh. That was random. Just a random earthquake. Hi, I'm just gonna, like, come around.
Thank you.
I remember the last time I caught you like that.
Yes. I wanted to sneak out of the castle, so I jumped from a window.
Wait.
That earthquake may have been Southern Rugnica falling.
What? Why?
Because Luke destroyed the Sephiroth tree supporting Southern Rugnica. It was barely hanging on by the Sephiroth from other areas. It's about time it fell.
What effect will that have on other regions?
Did you forget that we'd been having the Phone Master open the doors to the Sephiroth?
Even with the doors open, the passage rings are protected with Yulian seals. No one can use them.
Van can. In other words, Van is able to control the Sephiroth. Then, is his objective the further destruction of the Outer Lands?
That's what it looks like. From what I heard, the next to fall will be the area around St. Binah. I don't have time to play with you anymore. Goodbye.
Wow. Did he just... What? Did he just disconnect from himself?
I guess the channel's closed.
He closed the channel.
Master!
Mew.
And if you look outside into the darkness, you'll see someone. Looks like, someone is out there. Of course, it can only be one person. It's Tyr.
Oh yeah, St. Binah's in danger.
St. Binah is in danger. So Luke is probably gonna go to Tyr for some advice. Yep.
Luke, you're awake.
Is this a flower garden?
They're Selenias, the only flowers that grow in the Cliffoth. They bloom at night. The outer lands cover the sky, so hardly any sunlight gets through. Anyway, you look like you were worried about something.
Oh, right. I want to go back to the outer lands.
You'll be able to go back at some point, but for right now...
No, I have to go back now. Asch said St. Binah's gonna fall.
That facial expression is so priceless.
But you've been asleep this whole time.
I could hear. He and I are connected.
Even if that's true, how do you plan to prevent St. Binah from falling?
Well...
You don't understand a thing. You base all your actions on what others say and never try to understand things for yourself. That's no different than how you acted at Xeriuth.
You're right. Master Van said so. Asch said so. That's all I ever say. It's no wonder everyone got sick of me and left me behind.
You knew that they went back to the Outer Lands?
I told you, Asch and I are connected. I saw it through him. I really am his replica.
Luke.
Up till now, all I ever paid attention to was myself. And I'm not even sure I saw myself clearly.
Yeah.
I want to change. I have to change.
If you really mean that, then perhaps you can. But even if you change, that won't bring back Xeriuth, and it won't erase the fact that thousands died. With the weight of all that on your shoulders, how do you plan to change?
I don't know. That's all I know how to say. I'm pathetic. If I could make up for Xeriuth by apologizing, I'd apologize as much as it took. If my dying could bring back Xeriuth, then I'd be scared. But I'd die. But that's not how things are. Even if I tried to make up for it, I'd never be able to. So I'm gonna start with what I can do. I don't know what that is yet, but I'm serious. I want to change.
I still don't think you really understand. Not while you can talk about dying so easily.
I won't ask you to trust me right away. Tyr, you carry knives on you, right?
Yes. Why?
Let me borrow one for a minute. Tyr, I want you to watch me from here on out, and then make up your mind. I may not do a good job right away. I may make mistakes, but I'm going to change.
All right. I'll be watching you.
Please.
I will. But don't ever take it for granted. I can give up on you at any time. Anyway, right now, if Saint Binah is really going to fall, we have to find a way to stop it.
Right. But what should we do?
Let's ask the mayor, my grandfather. He should be in the meeting room.
Okay, let's go.
Those cutscenes were brilliant. That's kind of true too. Because a hero can do things right. But if you can actually take responsibility for your mistakes, that makes you a true hero, in my book. So, right now, you're going... actually got blown off guard by this. But you want to equip the Nimble Rapier and Ruby Wand to Tyr and to Luke. And if you want, you can also look at the fun phone slot core, the green one. The green one reduces TP or something. I'm going to leave that for later right now, because that's not something I want to do right now. We're going to go out of here. And then let's go here. I believe, right? Actually, no, wait. I need to go up here first. There. What's this? This is the roster. It contains a list of everyone living in Aldrond. Oh, it's missing some data. Say, Luke, I'm sorry to bother you with this, but could you help fill in this roster information? Or roster? It's roster, actually. Fuck it. Sure, but what do I do? Every time you meet someone significant, you just write down their information with this item. A character disc. If you do that, next time we open this book, information about the new people will automatically be added. Nice. It's not our most important priority, so just do it when you think of it. I'll go ahead and enter our own information right now. But I'm a replica. But you're still a resident of this world. Yeah, that's true. Actually, I forgot something. There is a item up here. I believe it's in his chest. Yeah, Skilled Forte. It's a it's one we're not gonna use right now. No, we're gonna get out of here. And oh, fuck! I forgot about something. I forgot to get the rice. Dang it! I don't have rice on me, do I? God damn it! I forgot the rice. Well, I'll get those later or something on the line. I wanna improve phonic defense for Tyr. But shit, I forgot about the rises. Anywho, you want to get the rises, give them to that guy. For later. I'm an idiot. I'm a really fucking big idiot. So, what you want to do is go to the conference room where we were earlier, up here.
Tyr, I was looking for you, about the third phonic hymn. Oh, so he's recovered? Layla, so has the third hymn symbol been discovered?
What's the third hymn? One of those phonic hymns you use?
So he doesn't know about them. The phonic hymns I use are Yulia's hymns. There are seven altogether.
Oh, so the third of those seven? Wait, you always just use two of them.
I don't understand the symbolism of the others. Yulia's hymns are useless with only the melody. If you don't understand the meaning and wisdom in the hymns, they're just songs. Oh, that's right. The symbol of the third hymn. There was a hidden page in a book Van left behind. It might be written there. When you have a chance, stop by my place and take a look.
symphonic hymns sound pretty tough.
Yes, the symbols are very difficult. I know all but the third and the fifth, but so far I only understand the first and second.
So if you don't know and understand the symbols, they really are just ordinary songs.
Actually, all seven of Yulia's hymns sung consecutively form another phonic hymn. It's called the Grand Phonic Hymn, and it works even if you don't understand its symbolism. The hymn itself is the symbol of the Covenant.
The whole Covenant with Lorelei Grand Phonic Hymn? What power does that have?
It's said that the Grand Phonic Hymn and the Key of Lorelei together can summon Lorelei.
That sounds amazing!
Yes, but the Key of Lorelei has been lost, and I don't know the seventh hymn, so it may not mean much in the end.
Cheer up. I don't know about the Grand Phonic Hymn, but your first and second hymns have really helped. That's good enough.
Luke, thank you.
He really has changed. Interesting. Which is a good sign. What you actually want to do is go down. God damn it, get out of my way. And just, there. You want to go in here, and this is a, like, if you want to go here, you cannot talk, you have to walk around it, like, what the hell?
I've been waiting for you. What's the book Van left behind? It's just an ordinary book on phonic arts, but there was a hidden page at the end. Here's a copy of it.
So Thera receives a copy
of
the
book. I don't know what it means, but I thought you might... This is... Va... Le... Sue... Tue... Mother, understanding, spreading through the land of Rugnica, the magnificent angel's voice.
What's going on?
Quiet. Tyr is meditating. It looks like that really was the symbol of the hymn.
Now I understand. This is the third hymn.
Holy Song. Really useful skill to have in a long battle, because Holy Song increases attack power, defense power, and heals the entire party.
Were you able to figure out the hidden whatever it was?
Yes. Congratulations, Tyr. Thank you. Do you mind if I keep this copy? There's information here about the symbolism in the other hymns as well. Though I don't yet know enough to understand them.
Be my guest. I'm sure it'll come in useful eventually as you grow stronger.
Yes. Thank you.
Alright. So now, Tyr's Holy Song. I'm gonna show it quickly. Use the third phonon to increase attack and defense of all allies and fill their HP. So it's a really good skill to have, at least for a long fight. Like, short fights, just not use them because it takes a while to cast and it's an expensive skill. But for a long fight, like a boss fight, Holy Song definitely comes in handy. So keep that in mind. Now we're gonna go back and speak to Teodoro, which is up here. Just the dude, the fucking loner in his room.
Oh, Tyr, it's you. And this must be...
Pleased to meet you. I'm Luke.
I'm you!
You, stay quiet. I apologize for what happened at Axarioth.
Ah, you're the Luke replica. I see. You really do look the same.
Grandfather!
Oh, I'm sorry. There's no need for you to apologize to us for Axarioth, however.
What do you mean?
The fall of Axarioth is written in Yulia's score. It occurred because it was meant to.
Wait, what?
What are you saying? I've never heard that. That makes it the same as Hod.
It's part of the closed score. Only those of Maestro rank or higher know of it.
If you knew about it through the score, why didn't you try to stop it?
Luke, I'm surprised to hear someone from the Outer Lands say such a thing. A calm, orderly life in accordance with the score is the way of the Order of Lorelei.
Well, yeah, but...
Why are people read the score on their birthday each year? To learn of the next year and accept the possibilities it holds.
Then why didn't you inform the world about Axarioth's destruction?
Yeah, if you'd let everyone know, people wouldn't have had to die.
That's the problem. When faced with a score of death, people become unable to live peacefully.
Of course, sir. Nobody wants to die.
Sir.
That's not acceptable. Yulia read prosperity for Aldrant in the score. If we don't move history down that path, we'll lose the prosperity we are promised. We are the Watchers who guide the Outer Lands to prosperity, based on Yulia's score. The Order of Lorelei is a tool for that purpose.
And that's where Grand Maestro Mose held Phone Master Ion and tried to cause a war?
Master Van knew about the score when he took me to Axeriuth?
That's correct.
You told me neither Malkuth nor Kimlaska listened when you warned them about Hod. Was that a lie?
I'm sorry. You were young. I didn't want to tell you the truth. But Van knows the truth.
Then my brother is planning to take revenge on the world. He said that a world shackled to the score is better off destroyed.
Tyr, you're mistaken in thinking that Van is trying to destroy the world. It's true that there was a time when Van hated the score after what happened to Hod. But now, he's doing an admirable job as an observer.
Admirable? Letting everyone in Axeriuth die was admirable? You're crazy! There's something wrong with all of you!
Not at all. At the end of the sixth phone stone, Yulia's score reads thus. The land of Rugnica will be enveloped in war, and Malkuth shall lose territory. Kimlaska Lanvildir shall thrive, and this shall lead to unprecedented prosperity. We have watched all this time in order to bring that unprecedented prosperity to the Outer Lands.
But Grandfather, Van is trying to cause Saint Binah to fall.
The battle will take place around it. Saint Binah will not fall. It is not written in the score.
Mayor Teodoro, it's time for the council meeting.
I'll be right there. If you two are that worried, take the Yulia Road to the Outer Lands. See for yourself that your concern is groundless.
Well, that was weird. I mean, this is basically says you're going to die tomorrow.
We aren't going to accomplish anything here.
If it's basically going to say you're going to die tomorrow, you're going to be like, ah, man, going to live it. Live my last day and stuff. It doesn't make sense.
Right. But before we go, there's something I want to get from my room, okay?
Sure.
There's something there. Okay. We're going to go back. I really wish there was a shop in this place so I can just buy the rice that the guy needs, but there isn't. Where's your room, Tyr? It's the room you were sleeping in. The second floor in the house next door is my room. Oh. And this whole time I was sleeping in Tyr's bed? Master, something wrong? No, let's go. That's felt a little bit awkward, didn't it? It's almost as if he's sorry that he slept in Tyr's bed. Well, she should be sleeping there, or he was excited. Or anything along the line. I can't really read his mind, but men are men, so you never know. Just gonna walk back here. And then up to the second floor, into Tyr's room.
Van hated the score. He was always talking about it, here in this room. He'd stand about where you are now, and say he could never forgive a world that let Hod die.
Why does he care so much about Hod?
The Isle of Hod was Malkuth land, destroyed in the Hod War 16 years ago. It was our home. Hod fell into the Cliffoth, just like Axeriuth. Van and my mother, who was pregnant with me, fell into the Cliffoth. Van probably used a faunic hymn. Something happened before I went to the Outer Lands. Van returned to this city, something he didn't do very often.
Asch seems to suspect something.
Flashback scene, much?
Asch is still a bit dainty. He'll cause trouble if he learns that the people of the Outer Lands will be annihilated.
Shall we have Sing keep tabs on him?
Yes.
I thought my brother was planning something terrible. At least that many people were going to die. I couldn't allow that to happen, even if Hod had been left to die because of the score. I swore I'd stop him, even if it meant killing both of us.
Tyr.
But it looks like I failed. I couldn't save Axeriuth.
That's because I
can't blame it all on you. I took an assignment in the Outer Lands in order to stop Van.
You're strong.
Am I? I wonder.
Too strong. Thanks for telling me about all this. I think maybe I understand you a little better now.
That's the first time you've ever thanked me for anything.
Really?
I'm so happy you two are growing close to each other.
It's not like that. By the way, what did you come here to get?
A book on phonology. I thought you would need it.
Why?
A hyperresonance is caused by seventh phonons. I think this will help you learn to control them.
Oh, thanks.
Principles of Phonology, which hopefully will get
the
me to control
road is to the right of the meeting
my
room. Let's
residence.
Go.
The Yulia Road is near the meeting room, or actually in the meeting room. So we're gonna go there. It's not that far. Yulia City is really small and stuff. So what you want to do is go up here And get out of my way. They want to go into this room. Yulia Road.
This path connects to the Aramis Spring on the Padamian continent. That place is crawling with monsters. Are you ready?
Damn straight I'm ready.
Yeah, I'm ready.
I'm scared.
It'll be all right, Mew. Here we go.
And we're gone. I have no idea what's going on. Apparently we're seeing something in the Cliffoth. Cliffoth? A horrible word for me to pronounce. And poof! Suddenly, we're at Aramis Spring. If you want to go back to the Cliffoth, this is the portal you have to use. Right there.
Whoa! It dumped us out into the water!
It's alright, you won't get wet.
How
weird.
Come?
Apparently, the force from the Sephiroth spout pushes the water aside.
Those Sephiroth things sure are strong if they can lift the whole land into the sky, and I destroyed one of them.
Standing around depressed isn't going to help anything.
You're right. I came back here to do what I can. Man, I'm hopeless.
You'll learn, Luke. You'll learn. So basically, if you want to go back to the cliff, I'll just stand here and press A to warp down there. I'm gonna do that later. Probably off-screen so I can get the rice. But not after we explore the Aramis Spring, which I will leave for the next episode, because this one has been going on for quite a bit, 21 and a half minutes at least. Hey, thank you for watching. In the next part, we'll explore Aramis Spring. So until then, see you next time.